Guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Tom. Welcome to the machine learning tutorial about KNN or K Nearest Neighbor. To make sure that everyone is on the same page, I just want to quickly mention that there's two forms of machine learning: supervised learning and unsupervised learning. For KNN, this is a supervised learning algorithm and can be used for classification and regression. So today, I will quickly mention about the intuition, definition of KNN, and the implementation of KNN using Python and Sklearn libraries. All right, so regarding KNN, let's imagine these classification problems, right? There's two classes, class A and class B. Class A is classified to be cats, and class B is classified to be dogs. And there's an unknown data point, an unknown creatures. We need to use KNN algorithm to classify this unknown point to be either cats or dogs. How do we do it intuitively? Intuitively, you want to measure distance between this red point to other points in the diagrams. And then we want to select the k-nearest neighbor to the red dot. Then we let them vote based on their classes. Majority wins. As simple as that. And for KNN, there are two ways to measure distances. The first way is using Euclidean distance, and second way to measure using Manhattan distance. In this exercise, I only talk about Euclidean distance because very common, really simple. Euclidean distance is defined to be the shortest distance between two points. I assume everyone knows about Euclidean distance, so we can move on. Next up, we need to select K. K value is defined to be the numbers of nearest neighbors next to the data point that we want to classify. Assuming k equal to 3, then we need to find k 3 nearest neighbor to the red dot. And two of them are class A and one of them are class B. 2 versus 1, majority wins. So this red dot would be classified to be class A. The things about it is different k value will yield different results. For example, when k equal to 7, we have 4 class B versus 3 class A. So majority wins again. So this red dot will be classified to be class B. All right. The question is, how do we select the best optimal k value? I have two thumb rules for you. The first one would be you should select a k value to be odd number, because you want to make sure that there is no situation that there is equal vote from both classes or from both parties. Then you would be in dilemma, right? And the second thumb rule is you want to select k value to be equal to the square root of number of data points in your data set. All right, enough talking. Let's move on to the implementation of KNN using Python and Sklearn, shall we? So the application we want to create this time is we want to apply the use case of creating machine learning model to predict if someone having a diabetes or not. You can download this data set on UCI website, or you can just use it on Kaggle. So Kaggle is a website that have all the public data set available for you to use, and it also allow you to create your own machine learning model to run with the website, to run with the data set. Without a need to install anything on your computer. I think it's very neat and convenient for us. So select Kima Indian diabetes. Select the first option. We'll have a look at the data set that they provide. There are 9 columns in total: pregnant, glucose, blood pressure, skin thickness, blah blah blah, to the outcome column. The outcome column is our target label column where we want to predict this column. 0 means no diabetes, 1 is having diabetes, and that's 768 rows in total. So let's create a kernel to actually interact with this data set so that we can run machine learning model on. Alright. Go to create notebook. Select Python Jupyter notebook. GPU off because our data set is really small and our machine learning model is very simple. And just press create. Okay. Next, we want to import a few important Python library. So let me quickly copy and paste the library here. Okay. So let me explain what this library can do. First of all, we have NumPy, which is really good for linear algebra. This is the numeric array. Next, we have Panda. It's good for data frame, to processing, and to open CSV file. The next six library are from sklearn. These two are from Python library. So we have the train test split. It's good to split our data set for training set and for testing set. And we have standard scaler, is to scale our data to be from negative 1 to 1. Make sure that our model is unbiased. And we have the K-neighbor classifier, is our main machine learning model for KNN. And the last three is for testing, confusion matrix, F1 score, accuracy score. I will explain more about it as we go on. First up, let's we import the library together, the CSV file together. Okay, so we have dataset equal to pd read CSV. And we just gonna copy this link and we're gonna print out our data set. Make sure that we got it. Beautiful. Next, we're gonna replace the zero value, because the zero value indicate that these are missing data or invalid data. And the best way to do it, the trick is to do it, is to replace the zero value to the mean of the column. All right, let's do it together. So we create a list or column name together. Let me quickly copy and paste this. Blood pressure, skin thickness, BMI, and insulin. Yeah. And we're gonna look through column together. So we want to replace these column. We want to replace zero value of this column with the NumPy NaN, which is not a number, indicate missing data or invalid data. And we calculate the mean of the column. Make sure that when we calculate the mean, we want to skip the NaN value. And next up, we're going to replace the NaN value with the mean. All right, so let's see if our data set got what we want. Cool. So as you can see that the zero value now replaced with the mean of the column, which is really good. Next up, we want to split our data set for training and for testing. All right, let's do it together. So we need to do data set. I located all the rows and from 0 to 7 column, and y equals data set. Take all the row and take the a column. Then we want to split these sets to be train set and test set. Train, test, split. X and Y, we got random stage. Random stage are seed random, so we can set them to be default to be 0. Test size equal to 0.2, for example. Then we This means that we're gonna take 20% of data set for testing and 80% for training. So let's run it. Looking good. No error. So next up, we want to scale our data properly. The thing is, as you know that, have a look at our data. The different column, they have a different wide range of, as you can see that for our data, different column, they have a wide range of value, could be ranging from 0 to 17 or 0 to 846. This is bad because our model could be biased and favor one features over other features. The best way we do it is we scale them from negative 1 to 1 equally. So we force our model to treat each features equally. So let's do it together, SCX equal to standard, scalar, right, so X train equal to SCX, fit transform X train, and the same thing with X test. Okay, let's run the code. Code, very good, no error. All right, let's move on the finding the optimal k value. As I mentioned that the optimal k value is the square root of numbers of data points in the data set. So you want to, and we only care about the testing set. So let's find the length of the y test. Right, so let's find the square root of that by import math and find the math square root. Yeah. Wow, and as I mentioned that the best k value is an odd number. So let's do 12 minus 1 is equal 11. Let's choose k equal to 11. And then we want to create our classifier model. Neighbor classifier neighbor. Our k equal to 11, p equal to 2 because there are only two classes, diabetes or not. The metric is Euclidean distance. That is pretty clear. We want to train our model by our model with X train and Y train. See if there any syntax error, classifier, not. Yeah. Put, very good. Right, so we want to use this model to predict our data. Let's do it. Let's use this classifier and predict our set. Run it. No error. Beautiful. Now we need to find a way to test our accuracy. Yeah. First of all, we need to use the confusion matrix, which is a really good indicator. I actually don't have time to talk too much about this stuff, but I can tell you briefly about how these things work. All right. So we need to bring out the F1 score of the Y test. And Y predict. So we're gonna do the same thing for the accuracy score. Alright, let's test it. Oh no, accuracy score with double C. Okay. No, okay. Alright, beautiful. So how do we interpret this number? Let's look at this line. You can see that there are four numbers, two positive, two false positive, two negative, and false negative. These two numbers mean that these two numbers are the instances where our model predict correctly. These two numbers are the numbers, the instances that our model predict incorrectly. So we are building a medical prediction. So we don't want this false negative to be high, because imagine you go to the hospital for checkup and the computer tell you that you don't have a diabetes, but actually you do have a diabetes, this could cost you your life. So if we want to commercialize our model, we want to put this poor negative to be small. Okay, the F1 score is objective because it consider both of the positive and negative of the true and false. So that's why data scientists, they really like F1 score, give them a very objective view of the model. Why the general public and the decision maker, they love look at the accuracy score, because this one only care about true positive and true negative. That's why accuracy always higher than F1 score. But I think this 80% is pretty good for our toy example. In summary, we talk about the KNN, we talk about how to choose K value, we talk about implementation of KNN, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you.